The save points, the loading times are at least quick. I have to give it that. It has much to load. It's the same damn textures all over again. Lock! Lock on! Lock on! Why can't I not lock on? There we go. Alright, so lock on is a little suspect. And there's blood on my screen again for some reason. And more of the same. Man, you thought you met weirdos in the New York subway. I must ask, is it really a kill count if they're already dead? Seriously, don't get... I don't know if I'm going to need to post this. I mean, it's just the same damn thing, slog over and over again. Let's try kicking a little bit. Kicking. There we go. Holy kick! Holy leg sweep! Like I said, the kicks don't actually do much damage. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. Why is her puncher so strong, but her kicks aren't that great? I mean, aren't girls, like, usually stronger with the lower body than the upper? Why am I questioning? Why am I fucking questioning this? Holy suplex! Holy suplex! Okay, now where? Holy spin! Holy suplex! Here's a question. How come Japan always has just zombies? I mean, Japan is supposed to be like the leading tech guys, right? So how come the Umbrella Corporation has outdone them in like leaps and bounds? I mean, they've still got shamblers, and we're already on to giant snakes, lizard men, and frickin' neck squigglies. God damn it! Pick up the power-ups and move on. They feel the need to question, what did they do? They don't fill out that little gauge that keeps turning yellow that I keep seeing. I think that's the kill counter. Next area, subway traffic, below basement floor 1. Man, Japan is just nothing but zombies! You know what really kind of disappoints me though? All these zombies, yet not one of them is in a red leather jacket. What do you think the janitorial squad is gonna be like when they get in here? I mean, there's only so many times you can bleach the same floor before you just say, fuck it, I'm painting it red. Where do you even find a chainsaw if you're a headless zombie? For that matter, how do you even find a chainsaw if you're a headless zombie? Oh, come on! How many of you guys are there? My hand's starting to get tired. Come on, I'm getting tired of waving my Wii at this lolly. Wow, that did not come out right at all. You know, there are only so many comments you can make in any one slogfest. Guys, come on, I've been more exhilarated playing Pong. Two-player. By myself. Wait a minute, why was I playing Pong by myself? Wait a minute, why do I own Pong? Oh, come on, like a person smelling that bad, living or dead, would just shake off a little girl who grabbed them. Is that everyone yet? Thank you. Okay, I believe I was going this way. Guys, come on! The heck, they can catch them now? the hell? Okay. Give it back! What the fuck? Okay, sword don't worky then. Go with punches. Punches work. Lolly! Punch! But what's happening? What? Rampage! Attacking enemy zombies will increase the splatter gauge. Once the splatter gauge is full, your character will go into a rampage. Characteristics during rampage. Attack power, attack speed, and attack range increase. Mudmen can be defeated by normal sword attacks. What's a mudman? Your character does not stagger or stop when hit by zombie attacks. The item Bloody Lump can be used to recover vitality. However, rampage also has the following demerits. Vitality gauge gradually decreases. Defense falls, meaning zombie attacks do greater damage. Rampages can be stopped by touching a goddess statue to purge the splatter gauge, or by using an item goddess fragment. Okay. So apparently my lolly's gone Super Saiyan. Yeah, looks about right. Oh, come on! What the fuck is wrong with my sword? I mean, you like clean it off. There we go. There we are. Okay, so my health gradually goes down. But it's the end of the level, so that's anyway. Level 4? What does the experience do exactly? 9-point get. Level 6. Sakaki leveled up. Saki. Why do I keep calling her Sakaki? It's Saki. Oh, I get. Now I get to level up. Okay. So, skill, vitality, power, and reach. Can't I just put them all into strength? Alright, what's skill do? Vitality, I guess, is health. I have 15 point get. So, I guess power is my attack power, so let's put a few points in that. Reach should be good. We need more strengthen the lolly, so not the point out of that. Put it into skill for some reason. Okay. These points will be sure. Why not? Chapter Kia. Took me half an hour because I went got lost. Say yeah, why not? Sure. Girl wraithed in darkness. Mata Shirio Taksan Kita. More of this fucking fuck it! I've killed many undead again, and as I did so, I started to enjoy it. The blood and the gore of the undead covering my entire body. This is getting really icky! This is really icky, Japan! What is with it in the lollies?! Feels indescribably good. I can't return to the normal girl that my sister wants me to be. This primal fighting instinct of baneful blood. What is it? Misery's parting words still linger confusingly in my heart. Does the baneful blood desire combat, or does the baneful blood simply respond to it? Oh god, there's more? I cannot understand your moon speak! If I continue to bathe in their blood like this, will I too turn into a monster like Misery or Himoko? Who the fuck is Misery and Himoko? If that happens, will Sis kill me? Save me by killing me? No, I mustn't think negative thoughts. Sis would get mad again. I'm pretty sure that the idea of, you know, turning into a monster or something is a good thing to, you know, want to go against. I just need to concentrate on meeting up with her. Skip! Oh, the skip button actually makes the text go faster. Alright, not to self. Use that next time. A girl rests in darkness. Cool combination attacks. Why do you keep showing me a character I'm not using? If you swing the Wiimote and precise timing with the sword, you perform a sword combination attack. Swing the next attack the instant the previous one hits. You'll be perform faster, stronger, cool combination attacks. Mastering sword combinations allows you to fight more fluidly and gracefully. Press the C button on the Nunchaku to switch your character's fighting style. For example, Aya, single sword mode or double sword mode. Saki, single sword mode or beat mode. God, how much instruction do I need? Gradually attacking enemies with your sword will gradually cover your sword and your character in blood due to the blood splatter given off by the enemies. This represents by an increase in the sword's gore gauge and splatter gauge. As the sword gore gauge increases, sword attack power will fall along with the speed of pulling the sword free of enemies. If the gauge fills up completely, the sword will get totally stuck. Okay, so that... You could have told me that before! If this happens, rapidly swing the remote to free it. Would have been useful to know before. Reload and quick reload. A sword's gore gauge increases as the attack power will fall along... Yes, you just told me that. Reload can be formed in order to clean the sword and gore up your form. Also, perform a special reload by certain specific actions, if possible, to reload it faster or quicker reload. What do you call it a reload when it's a clean? Although a quick reload does not clean much blood off the sword, it also finishes very quickly, leaving you less time exposed by attacking from enemies. In other words, kill shit, don't let it kill you. Shit! A dominatrix and a lolicon. This is not good. Madam, are you only wearing the front part of that outfit? You are. Great. So, what does this all have to do with zombies again? Oh, tits. Yeah, that's it. Alright. And now it comes down to one of the great debates of our otaku generation, flat chest versus double D's. Now, while at first the flat chest may appear to provide more mobility and ease of movement, the counterbalance of the double D's does offer for some more interesting acrobatic maneuvers. Oh, stiletto to the face! That's gotta hurt. Let's try beat style here. Beat some face! Olip! Punch! Wait a minute. She's got a gun? You're allowed to bring a gun to a sword fight? Let alone that's a pump-action shotgun that she's single-handedly wielding. Why am I even questioning this logic? That sword's getting pretty bloody. Run away! Come on, clean, 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 clean. There you go. Ow! Shotgun! I don't have any way to guard, do I? Let's do a barrel roll! Oh shit. Crap, she went into the devil trigger mode thing. Oh, doesn't that mean she'll take just damage over time? These bosses seem kind of easy if you can just wait them out once you get them down to a certain point. Oh, yeah, shit, that was easy. Okay, so boss is not really anything to worry about, but we leveled up in the process. Good, good, good. Stronger Lolly, 3-point get! 6-point get! Point there, couple points there. Why not? I have no idea what these do, really, so... Sure. Chapter clear! Why not? Despicable bloodline. Game, you don't have a story. Stop pretending that you do. She wasn't like the Riko I encountered before. I don't know how to put it. Well, I sense the humanity in her for the first time. A sample of baneful blood, if it was supposed to totally remove all the baneful, if it was possible to totally remove all the baneful blood from my body, I could become a regular girl, a sister to Aya. Maybe I wouldn't have to swing a sword anymore. Maybe I could walk in the sunlight. What, so she's a vampire too? Only vampire, huh? Okay. You know what? I'm not even gonna bother with this stupid tacked on storyline bullshit. Skip. Come on. There you go. Seriously. Despicable bloodline! Why do you keep showing me this character? Swing the Wiimote while holding down the 1 button, special attack button, perform each character's unique special attack. The attack will consume a little of your character's vitality gauge, but unleash a powerful blow. Depending on the character and your current character move and conditions, use will greatly affect combat when used skillfully. You can also rapidly swing the Wiimote prior to your attack to build up an even more powerful, stronger attack. Special command moves. Each character has their own special command moves. Press the Z button on the nunchuck to lock on, and they can use two horns to spread special motions. Some moves cannot be used by certain characters. Thrust attack. Push the control stick forward while locked onto an enemy to win the thrust. Okay. Upward slash. Push the control stick backward while locked. At least they're explaining the fucking controls, however fucking gradually. Okay. Upwards. If the enemy hits an enemy, you'll be sent into the air. Clear out slash. Put the control stick to left or right while locked on to swing the remote horizontally. Leg sweep. Push the control stick backwards while locked onto an enemy and rapidly swing the nunchuck. If it's the enemy, they'll fall over. Okay, so... There's a side slash. There's a forward slash. The back slash. And I think I can only do the leg sweep like this. Alright, leg sweep to kick. So... There we go, leg sweep, there we are. Leg sweep! Sweep the leg! Sweep the leg! Yeah, we'll go Karate Kid on you! Or something like that. Karate Kid versus the undead. Isn't that like Karate Kid 5? You know, the one where the Karate Kid goes out to this cabin in the middle of the woods and he plays this recording on the A-tracks and the deadites start showing up and... Wait, that's the Evil Dead. Oh, zombie cops' pistols can shoot. Okay, so zombie cops have pistols. Wait a minute, this is Japan! You don't have guns in Japan! But by using Sakaki's throw to tear- Shit, you can tear off their arms?! Oh, zombie birds, of course. They're hard to hit with sword attacks. Get use and use upward slash or use ranged attacks such as Aya's knife throws? I have ranged attacks? How do I do those? Zombie birds can swoop in from the sky. Oh, shit. Oh crap, the zombie cop, immediate threat! Guard break, kick, go, go, go! Okay, so, either grab him or just cut him up. Kill this thing. Okay, let's go, come on. God damn it, it's not bad enough I have the zombie apocalypse, I gotta fit up with the birdemic as well? God. Quick, find a coat hanger! Okay. Just gonna start... Lolly suplex! Oh, shit! That is the lolicon equivalent of Beowulf! Okay, so once you figure out the controls here, I guess they are actually kind of responsive now that I know what I'm supposed to be doing. They're a little particular, but they're responsive at least. Fucking bird. Fucking bird! Wah! Off of the blood. Bird, you do realize you're supposed to fly around the pole, right? Still, they are less annoying than the grenade parrots. Come here, bird! Die, pants! The pants are dead! Oh, come on! Seriously, how many of you guys... Wait a minute, she's out in the sunlight! See right there, look! No problem at all! Okay, so what the fuck was all that about? Oh shit, that one's got a daisy air rifle! Massive threat there. Actually, can I take the rifle and use that as my ranged attack? No, I guess not. Not that kind of game. I'm also not entirely sure what kind of game it is, but another daisy air rifle! Remove it! Or suplex, that works too. Wonder if I can tear the limbs off other zombies. Nope. Nope. Do I have to have the chainsaw? Nope. Okay, run around, pick up some gear. Good, good. Yeah! The spin throw actually seems to be a really good way to rack up hits in crowded areas. Not so useful one-on-one, though. Come on! There we go. And the pants are dead. What is with the spike cages? Is that ever explained? Do I even want it to be explained? Next area. Electronics district. Yay, electronics! Maybe I'll find, like, some techno zombies here. Or just more of the same. Yeah, more of the same, probably. The fucking birds! Fucking birds! At least they don't fly too high. Level up! Now, do I gain experience by collecting those little yellow orbs, or by just killing things? Alright, and I'm starting to get a lot of blood on me, and I think I see a Schwein thingamajig there, so... Let's just clear out this area. It's probably gonna take another half an hour, considering they just keep coming. Alright, thank you. Alright. Bowie sprint! Oh, it's a trap! Seriously, are those bones or spears or what? Why do these pop out of the ground at odd angles? You know, I just noticed a good couple of these zombies here are wearing red flannel shirts. Like fighting an army of undead lumberjacks? Just a bazillion damn tourists. You know, it's times like this when I long to hear the thundering cry of Godzilla as he topples over Tokyo Tower for the 26th time. And since when could zombies use guns? Oh, I found something. Cool. I know what it is. Oh shit, I think I got shot there. Oh, he's suplex! The birds. Alright. Going a little bit further here. Die, bird! Okay, I'll just take care of you two, and then that is it. The hell? Where do you go? There you are. Fucking teleporting zombies. Okay, this ought to... Area, God's Goddess Statue, safe chamber. Yay, I have been saved. Restart, quit options. Okay, well, as I cannot figure out how to save in the save room, I will catch you guys later. This has been Let's Random Play Onichanbara Bikini Zombie Slayers. I hope you guys will have a safe and happy Halloween, and as always, catch you later!